Hello and welcome to the how-to video of how to set the prioritization on your Fronius wattpilot device. In this video, we want to show you how to set the prioritization between your Fronius wattpilot, the Fronius Ohmpilot, and of course the stationary PV battery system. So in this case, we want to give you the opportunity to control your energy management functionality and to make sure that the energy flow management is always at your use case. So depending on how you want to use the system and to optimize your personal sector integration. Yeah, first of all, to set the settings, we need to have our Fronius Solar wattpilot app. And on the start screen of the Solar wattpilot app, you can now see down below the point settings. Please note, this video is being recorded with the software version of 1.5.0. And of course, if you are setting any settings in the app here that you can't redo, you can always use the RFID reset card to reset the wattpilot to factory settings. In this case, just use the reset card, hold it at the front of the device and reset the wattpilot to its factory settings to redo any settings that you have done to the wattpilot. Yeah, here in the settings, you can see here the point smart settings, and there you will find the point cost optimization. And when you click on cost optimization, you can enter the PV optimized settings. When you now scroll down to the PV optimized settings, you can find now here the point use PV surplus, the inverter, and the PV surplus advanced settings. These points, they were disclaimed in another video. So if you're interested in this, please watch our other video as well. Yeah, now to the prioritization process. So what do we want to do here? First of all, we have two threshold settings. This is the PV battery, the stationary PV battery, and of course the Ohmpilot threshold. And these settings are being factory setted to 20% state of charge, so 20% SOC, and 20 degrees of Celsius of the Ohmpilot hot water boiler. So with these two thresholds, you can define for yourself on how you want to use the energy within your system. So let's say you want to make sure that the wattpilot will use the PV surplus energy charging, and of course you want to make sure that the wattpilot has a relatively high prioritization. So in this case, we can set the PV battery threshold, for example, to 10% state of charge, and the Ohmpilot threshold to only 10 degrees of Celsius. So in the first example, we want to make sure that the wattpilot gets the energy first and to make sure that the electric vehicle is being charged whenever it is plugged in. So in this case, when you set the PV battery threshold to 10%, then the Fronius inverter will make sure that the PV battery is being charged at least to 10%. And after this value, then the wattpilot will get the energy. Second threshold is the Ohmpilot value, and this value needs also to be sure. So in this case, at 10 degrees of Celsius, and as soon as the 10 degrees of Celsius are being reached in the hot water boiler, then the wattpilot will get the energy. So whenever you want to operate the wattpilot, these two values, the PV battery threshold and the Ohmpilot threshold, they need to be fulfilled by the Fronius system. And as soon as these parameters are fulfilled, then the wattpilot gets the energy. So as you see, with this you can put in your own prioritization, and when you want to have the wattpilot on prioritization number one, then you set these values to relatively low value. So in this case, 10% state of charge, this will be most of the time be met. And of course also 10 degrees of Celsius in the hot water boiler, this value will also be met most of the times. So therefore the wattpilot will get the energy first. Second thing, of course, please note, and this is really important, regarding to the prioritization between the Ohmpilot and the stationary PV battery system, these prioritizations, they need to be set extra in the web interface of the Fronius inverter. So under the energy management functionality there, you can set a prioritization between Ohmpilot and PV battery storage. So therefore, you can set this prioritization, for example, to PV battery storage number one, so this has the highest priority, and second priority Ohmpilot. And then in regards to that, you can set here your thresholds in the Solar wattpilot app. So this always works together, so to say, as two systems, and you need to figure out the wattpilot settings on the Solar wattpilot app as well as the web interface settings on the Fronius inverter. So this was the first example with wattpilot and prioritization number one. Second example is now that we want to prioritize the stationary PV battery system. So in this case, we will give the PV battery system a relatively high value, so let's say 95% state of charge, to make sure that the inverter will first of all charge the battery storage to a very high state of charge, and after that give the energy to the Wattpilot. So in this case, we leave the Ohmpilot at the relatively low value. So for example, 5 degrees of Celsius, this will always be met. So therefore, your PV stationary battery will be charged first, then the Wattpilot, and at the rest, when there is energy left, then the Ohmpilot will also be operated. Yeah, and in the third example, we want to prioritize the Fronius Ohmpilot, and therefore we want to make sure that we set here a relatively high temperature. So for example, 60 degrees of Celsius, and the PV battery threshold, we set it down to 10% state of charge. So this would mean that the Ohmpilot will now be operated until there's a hot water temperature of 60 degrees of Celsius. And when the state of charge, the SOC level of the stationary battery is at 10% and the hot water is at 60 degrees of Celsius, then the Wattpilot will get the energy. Plus to that, of course, you need to change the prioritization in the web interface of the inverter and set the Ohmpilot prioritization number 1 and the PV battery stationary battery to prioritization number 2. In this regards, then the inverter will make sure to first operate the Ohmpilot, then operate the stationary battery system, and as soon as 60 degrees and 10% state of charge are being reached, then the Wattpilot will get the energy. So as you see, with these settings, you can always prioritize your charging, and depending on your needs, depending on your wishes, you can now prioritize the Wattpilot to a relatively high level or wherever you want to have it. Yeah, factory set it. These values are being set to 20% state of charge and 20 degrees of Celsius. This is due to the fact that most customers, of course, want to make sure that whenever the car is being plugged in, they want to make sure that it is being charged. 20% state of charge would mean that there is a minimum level of energy in the PV stationary battery system, so they can use it for the nighttime consumption, for example. And the Ohmpilot at 20 degrees of Celsius, this is relatively easily set because 20 degrees of Celsius is relatively fast being set in the Ohmpilot or in the hot water boiler. Yeah, and if these two values are now being set, then the Wattpilot will get energy relatively early, and therefore this is a very good value for the factory settings that we have chosen here. So if you want not to prioritize your loads, then you can use these factory settings as well, of course. Yeah, whenever you are done with the configuration here, please hit also the save button on the right top corner to save the settings. And from now on, your Wattpilot will use the energy depending on your needs and depending on your wishes. So I hope this was informative for you, and you can now configure the Wattpilot to your specific settings and make sure that the Wattpilot is charging on your terms. So stay calm and keep charging. See you the next time here at Fronius. Goodbye.